India is known for the many rivers that flow across the land. There are 12 major rivers that have been considered to be holy. The devout believe that taking a dip in any of these rivers can rid them of their sins. Rivers like the Ganga, Godavari and Saraswati are believed to be goddesses. In the south, the rivers are worshipped and annual events are called Pushkaranis. And it's time for the Pushkarani off River Kaveri. What is this auspicious event all about? Where is it taking place? We give you all these details in this Newsline special.
Pushkara means festival of rivers. Kaveri Pushkara to begin on 12 September. Pushkara this time around is considered very auspicious. All thanks to Mahalaya Amavasya. Indian culture is known for its festivals. Each festival has a significance, a connect. The nature, people, animals, anything living or dead has a deep meaning that is not easy to understand. In the same way, the rivers found in our country are also given the status of gods and goddesses. The grandeur and majesty of the rivers may have persuaded the people of yore to treat them like goddesses. But the bounty that the rivers and their role in sustaining life has got them the status of female deities. Also, the devout believe the rivers to be sacred. In fact, so sacred that bathing in the rivers was considered to rid you of your sins. Pushkaras are the festival to celebrate the rivers, a kind of thanksgiving to the rivers for sustaining life. This time it is the festival of River Kaveri. This river, which is born in Talakaveri in Kodagu district, runs across Karnataka, flows into Tamil Nadu to finally join the sea. For millennia, its water has sustained life in southern Karnataka and central Tamil Nadu, irrigating thousands of acres of land. Of late, the river is getting less and less in flow, sparking off occasional battles between the two states, which have resulted in violence and deaths. After 12 years, the Kaveri Pushkara is being celebrated, and this time it falls between the dates 12 September to 23rd September.
This auspicious moment is particularly for this Kaveri Pushkaras. Actually, first of all, we should understand what is this Pushkaras and how the Pushkaras will come. See, Pushkaras has been came from a from Pushkar. Pushkar is a person who had prayed Lord Shiva, and with his blessings, Shiva's blessing, he had asked Shiva that I want to be the complete leader and adhipati for all the rivers. So Shiva had given anugraha, like given his blessings to Pushkara that you will be take caring of the all the rivers, Punya Tirthas, with your presence. Later, after fewer years, Burhaspati, he want to take the importance of leading this all Punya Nadi, Punya Tirtha Jalas. So he prayed Brahma that he want to be the part of this. As Pushkara had already got this from Shiva, and Pushkara is already staying in the Brahma Kamandala, so Brahma had asked that I want to give the same thing to Brihaspati. So he said, if you want to give the same element to Brihaspati, then what about me? Then in that situation, Brahma had said that Pushkara will give the very punya phala to each and every living being only when Brihaspati is in the movement from one rasi to another rasi, when it is changing from one river to other river.
This time, however, the Pushkara is said to be very auspicious because it falls on Mahalaya Amavasya. Pushkaras for 12 planets. Shifts in planetary positions brings about changes. This time Jupiter is moving into Tula Rashi or Libra. This is an annual phenomenon. According to Hindu calendar, every year the planet Jupiter or Guru to Hindu calendar transits from one Rashi or zodiac sign to another. This takes place once in a year.
Particularly next we will, if we consider in 2017, what are the auspicious days in this Pushkaras? First of all the 12 days in this Pushkaras, from if you see this, when the Pushkaras are starting on 12 to 23rd, it will be there. In these days every day is a good day, but if you see particularly in 2017, in my observation, because in my astrological calculations and observation, I have found out 5 very very auspicious days in this Pushkaras. Particularly first 3 days are very auspicious to take a holy dip in the Kaveri river, particularly holy bath in this Pushkaras. And particularly on 20th of September, it is a Mahalaya Amavasya, and I can say that it is a very 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 auspicious day to have a Kaveri Pushkara bath, because it is a Mahalaya Amavasya. And it is particularly when Brihaspati is in Tula Rasi and Bhadrapada Amavasya, and it is in Kaveri Pushkara Samaya, it is an excellent auspicious day to have a bath in this Kaveri River Pushkaras. And in Kaveri River Pushkaras, in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, there are very famous places, very famous temples. Like in Karnataka, Srirangapatnam is there. In Tamil Nadu, Srirangam is there. If people do bath at Srirangapatnam or Srirangam, this is a very very auspicious for them, and they will have even Talakaveri. If they have their bath at Talakaveri, it is a very very auspicious for them, and people, if they follow this, it will be very very excellent for them.
So whenever the Jupiter transcends into a planet, that time is when the Pushkara is celebrated. For each planet or Rashi, a river is associated, hence the Pushkara for each river.
How the Pushkaras come is, Pushkaras come into existence with the movement of the Brihaspati, that is Guru, that we call it as Jupiter. When Jupiter is changing from one Rashi to the other Rashi, when Jupiter is transferring, suppose when Jupiter is in the Mesha Rashi, Ganga River will be having Pushkaras. In North India they may call it also Kumbh, but it is in the Ganga River Pushkaras. And when it is like, suppose if the same Jupiter is on the Simha Rasi, it was Godavari River Pushkaras. When the Jupiter is in Kanya Rasi, it was Krishna River Pushkaras. Now in 2017 September on 12th, that is on Tuesday, Jupiter is entering on the early morning 6:05 a.m. Jupiter is entering into Tula Rasi. So when Jupiter is entering into Tula Rasi, it is a Kaveri River Pushkaras. Tula Rasi is having a very very importance related to Kaveri Pushkaras, related to the very famous temples of Mahavishnu in the southern part, in the South Indian part. If you see, in the South Indian part, there is a very very importance related to Tula Masa. On the Tula Masa, they perform prayers to even Kaveri, even they do prayers to Sri Mahavishnu. So particularly when Brihaspati is coming to Tula Rasi, Kaveri Pushkaras are happening.
Jupiter enters Mesha Rashi, river Ganga. Jupiter enters Vrushabha Rashi, river Narmada. Jupiter enters Mithuna Rashi, river Saraswati. Jupiter enters Karkata Rashi, river Yamuna. Jupiter enters Simha Rashi, river Godavari. Jupiter enters Kanya Rashi, river Krishna. Jupiter enters Tula Rashi, river Kaveri. Jupiter enters Vrishchika Rashi, river Bhima. Jupiter enters Dhanusha Rashi, river Tapti. Jupiter enters Makara Rashi, river Tungabhadra. Jupiter enters Kumbha Rashi, river Sindhu. Jupiter enters Meena Rashi, Mahadai. People believe that bathing in the holy rivers during the time of Pushkara brings them good luck.
What is the major importance in the Pushkaras? In Pushkaras, what we should do? In Pushkaras, we have to particularly do four things. In Pushkara, Snana, Dana, Japa, Tapa. So what is this, I will tell you. First important thing is Pushkaras is Pushkara Snana. Any person who do bath on the day in Pushkaras, particularly in the Kaveri River, so they will be, it is said that unknowingly if they have done any sins or anything, first of all that will be cleared and they will get some punya. Leaving this apart, we will speak something scientifically also. It has been clearly observed by few people, researchers, even our Rishi Munis, that at the time of this Pushkaras, at the moment of this Brihaspati, there is lot of some internal energy which is moving in the river, which will help in the health point of view, as well as in the manasika ullasa, particularly for the peacefulness of the mind and everything, by doing a bath in that river, it will definitely help. Second thing is, in this Kaveri Pushkaras, snana means how to do. Normally people think that if I need to do bath in the Kaveri Pushkaras, they take a soap, they take a shampoo, they go there and they do, but which should not be done. Actually, Pushkara Snana, Punya Snana means how it has to be done is, first of all, any river, any Pushkara, any Punya Kshetra, if you need to bath, first of all, you have to do bath in your house. First, you have to do your bath, you should clear from your side, from your house, and you have to go to that river at that time. Suppose, if I want to do Pushkara Snana at 6:05 a.m. on the early morning on the Kaveri River, so first of all, in my home, I will do my normal bath and I will go to the Pushkara Ghat, where I will go there, and there try to wear dhoti or anything. If not possible, wear your casual dress, whatever you feel. Try to remove your shirts, t-shirts, banin and all if men are there. Women can bath with their proper clothing and all, that is not issue. First of all, they have to go and they have to, first of all, they have to put a namaskara and pray Kaveri River. They have to touch with the hands the river and they have to do the sparsha of both eyes. Once they do this, they have to enter the river by placing their right leg inside, and they have to take 3 dips and complete the snana. And particularly, if they want to do something more, they can take the sand inside the river and they can bath with that sand, or they can carry haldi, chandan, kumkum along with them and they can do the bath. But they should not use any soaps or shampoo or these kind of things. And that means they have to do only, they have to take 3 dips and they can apply the haldi or kumkum on this and they should come out. And they should not, in Shastra it is never ever written that go and pollute the river. It has been said that take 3 dips so that it will give manasika santulana, it will give energy, it will give punya phala.
The speciality of Kaveri Pushkara this year is that it has fallen in the eve of Pitrupaksha, and the main day of celebration has coincided with Mahalaya Amavasya.
2017, what is the major importance of this Kaveri Pushkaras? So if you observe the thing, in 2017 September, Bhadrapada Bahula Paksha, that is Bhadrapada Krishna Paksha, that is near to Mahalaya Paksha. When we are in the Mahalaya Paksha, Pushkara is coming. It is a very, very auspicious day. And we will be really blessed by Pitru Devatas and Devatas if any person is having bath, particularly in Kaveri Pushkara at this time.
The 15 days of Pitru Paksha is the time when many families offer prayers to their ancestors. The devout believe that their sins are washed away and their ancestors' souls find peace if they bathe in the rivers during Pushkaras.
Actually, every person we have to do Pitru Tarpanas on Amavasya Purnami days in every month. But due to current in Kali Yuga, due to our daily jobs, works, everything, people are unable to do. If they are unable to do these kriyas, they have mentioned that on Bhadrapada Amavasya, Mahalaya Amavasya, if you do, we will consider all the 1 year has been done on the thing. Suppose there are few people who are unable to do these things on those days also. So for them, particularly for doing Pitru Devata Karma, normally every year people who have passed away for that, on the same tithi, people used to do the karmas, but due to certain reasons, if they are unable to do in that year, particularly in this Pushkaras, in these 12 days, if they have performed that Pinda Pradana Dana Karma on these 12 days, the Pitru Devatas will be satisfied and they will give their blessings to the people. So not only this, and there are people, like suppose if anyone has passed away suddenly in their traveling, even when they are in Kedarnath or some yatras or some places, suppose if anything had happened, and in the situation the people, they don't know at what date or time the situation has been happened. So for those kind of people, these Pushkaras plays a very important role in doing this karma related to Pitru Tarpanas, Danas, Pinda Pradanas and all the things.
But which are the places designated for the ritual baths? Thala Kaveri and Sri Rangapatna in Karnataka and Sri Rangam in Tamil Nadu are the places where devotees take a bath on Pushkara Day. People can take bath in the Kaveri River in any part of the state in either Karnataka or Tamil Nadu. However, if people take bath near holy places like temple, then the benefits are double.
First is snana, second is dana. Dana means it comes pinda dana, pitru devata dana. Even in the 12 days, there are 12 types of danas like rice, wheat. You can also do dana of gold, silver. There are a lot of things which you can do. In this Pushkara Snana, any dana if you are doing to poor people, poor children, even some Brahmin or anyone, even go dana, if you are giving some food to go also. So it is a very auspicious. So dana is a second part which plays a very important key role in Pushkaras. And tapa and japa, people who are doing tapa, japa, even yoga, by sitting on the banks of Kaveri River, after taking the bath, if they have this yoga, if they have dhyana, japa, it is a very, very auspicious. So I request everyone to follow these things and everyone to maintain cleanliness. Suppose in Kaveri, cleanliness means if in Kaveri Pushkaras, if they want to keep dhya and all, don't put dhya in in any waste paper or anything. Dhya should be made with maida. They should make diyas with wheat or anything, and on that diya, if they have placed, after that wheat will be eaten by fish or any water living animal, so that it will be also taken as a blessing. So you should not you try to see that you should not you don't throw any wastage of puja items in the river or anything. Just try to maintain the Kaveri River clean and have a peaceful and nice Kaveri Pushkara snana and earn good punya.
While the religious visit these places during Pushkara out of belief, those not the devout also visit the Pushkara locations for the sure experience. Prabhakar Sharma advises the visitors of Pushkaras to maintain cleanliness scrupulously. Devaya for News 9, Bengaluru.